From a hat podcast at gmail.com. Bone house.
All right, everyone, how are we? That's pretty good. Glad to hear it. I won't bother you too long, just thought I'd let you know that there won't be a new episode out next week, that being the 14th of November. I've started a new job and I kind of need to focus on that real quick, but everything should be back to normal the week after. Anyways, enjoy the show. Or don't. I'm not the fucking boss of you.
Welcome from a hat, the show where you're a topic out of a hat. Just like it says in the title, I'm Ben.
What order do we do it? You're not at the end.
Then
you go. Phoenix.
I'm Dom.
We always go right to left,
yeah, that's
regardless of where I am.
I feel like Dom should have started it.
Okay, well, next episode I'll start.
That's just not happening.
Okay, well, we'll come to that decision.
Who's drawing?
Looks like no.
I'll draw. Yeah, why not? Draw. Here we go. I'm mixing through.
Did you want me to move to the end?
No, it's fine.
We can all shuffle around. It'll make for good audio.
Yeah. What'd you get?
Defeat a classic villain from the movies.
Okay.
It's what it says.
Okay, like a classic movie villain.
Yeah.
Like Frankenstein or...
Right. Because Frankenstein a villain? Because I always kind of related.
The Doctor. Yeah.
So true. Yeah.
Anyway. So theme song?
Well, we're doing villains, so...
Maybe
so.
Sit up, for fuck's sake.
So...
I can be your hero, baby.
Boom, 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 boom.
I can kiss so away your pain.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, alright, cool.
Let me be your hero. Would you dance if I asked you to dance? Would you run and never look back? Would you
cry? By defeat, I assume it means kill.
Well, you say that, but it doesn't necessarily mean kill. You could just best it at a game of chance.
Yeah, but that's stupid.
Play the fiddle a little better, you know? But I'm more concerned with what actually clarifies as a classic movie villain.
Okay, so, because I come up with all these fucking things.
Yeah.
It's like the classic monster movie villains.
Right.
So, like, the Wolfman, yep. The Mummy, yep. The Creature from the Black Lagoon. Uh-huh.
Dracula.
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 Son of Dracula. Blackula.
Okay.
Frankenstein's monster. Frankenstein himself.
Uh-huh.
The Invisible Man.
Yeah.
Okay, there's a lot of them.
Kay. The Fly.
The Fly.
So, I'm gonna start this
Is
off.
Is that Bono? I'm not sure if you guys know that about Bono, but he has an alternate personality called The Fly.
Of course.
Yeah.
I didn't. Why do you know this about Bono?
I'm actually like a huge U2 fan.
I regret
good band, right? They're a really good
They're
band.
Really good. You should listen to their latest album. It's actually like one of their
Is
best.
Is that the
Songs
one?
Of Experience.
It's Wait, no.
Not Innocence. Not the iTunes line.
Songs of Innocence was good,
it's
though.
It's alright. It's better than a lot of people give it credit
yeah,
for.
Yeah, I like it.
Because everyone, it was forced on everyone yeah. on iTunes.
I'll have
anyway,
to listen to their new album.
Yeah, honestly, go out, check it out. I'm glad we're plugging you
I'm
to
gonna ask
show.
You not to play with your water bottle while we record.
Sorry, good point. Okay.
I could defeat the Invisible Man at a not being invisible contest.
No.
Okay, that's
You've
cheating.
You've got to be, you can't pick the fucking, it's a fight.
Okay.
Okay.
So.
Zordon, bringer of thought and space time!
Hey, Zordon.
Hey, how's it going? I think this is the first time I've, like, actually met you, where you've just shown up.
Yeah!
Last time I tried to summon you and I sort of got a sense of your presence, but actually seeing you in person, man, you've got a huge dick.
Yes, it's made of corn! It's just a big corn cob!
If I could just nibble on that for a second.
Well, tough, we've gotta go fight a monster movie villain. Toodaloo, fuckers!
So that happened.
I'm gonna miss that guy. Ben, you should've... I feel like you and Zordon would really get along. You should, like, speak up next time.
No, I don't like him. He fucked my wife.
Well, I mean, some guys are into that.
I mean, some bum had to.
Anyway... Destroyed.
So as are the classic rules of Sword on Bringer of Corn and Space-Time, we get thrown in with anything we could conceivably have on us.
Okay.
You're wearing the clothes you are now.
Yeah.
You're allowed what's in your pockets now.
Uh-huh.
And one other item that you own that you could conceivably have.
Okay.
You must defeat them in a fight to the death.
Okay.
I choose the creature from the Black Lagoon.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
Because...
he's a fish man.
He's a gill man.
Yeah.
Okay.
I own a baseball bat.
Sure.
I'll just womp him to death.
I'm just gonna look up his strengths and weaknesses.
I'll just womp him with my baseball bat.
But what if he's immune to baseballs?
He's I'm not hitting him with
the baseball bat.
Well, then I'm in trouble. But that's fine, I'll just keep womping him. Nothing's immune if you hit it enough.
I don't know if I agree with that.
It's like D&D rules.
You know, just keep chipping away at his health.
You know how, like, even if you're resistant to the damage, it still does damage.
Yeah, but you can be immune to damage.
Yeah, but, you know.
Okay, let's see what we got about him. None of this is helpful.
Alright, so what's Gillman got?
I'm still looking. I mean, he can clearly breathe underwater. People actually call him Gillman.
Yeah, because he's a Gillman.
Sure.
This is something that confused about. Why do you own a baseball bat?
Why wouldn't I own a baseball bat?
Do you not?
I don't.
There's two of us and one of you. You're the weird one.
Yes, it's true. But why do you guys... have you played baseball?
No.
I have a baseball and a bat in case I ever feel like going out to the pitch.
The batting cages and just pitching yourself a ball and then hitting it.
You could go with someone. It's a romantic date.
So true.
I have a suit vest and like an old-timey newsie cap and I wanted to look like an old-timey street tough.
That's fair. You could have got a Tommy gun.
But I don't want a Tommy gun. I want a baseball bat.
Because baseball bat, you're definitely going to get the real thing.
Mm.
Okay, what's the baseball bat made of?
Wood.
Wood? That'd get pretty wet, which means you can't light it on fire.
I don't want to light it on fire. I want to smack him with it. I'm going to bash his brain in. His gill brain. Get rid of his gill head.
Okay,
it doesn't really seem like he can do anything.
Yeah, because he's useless, because he's a gill man. That's why I'm going to hit him to death with a baseball bat.
But,
He's got claws.
You're forgetting about terrain advantage. Where is this fight taking place? Is it in the water?
I feel like I have to go to his lagoon.
Yes, that's what I'm saying. Otherwise, it's too easy. Why would he go out to agree to fight you in, what, the middle of a baseball field with your bat ready? No, that's not how this happens, bro. You're wandering to the baseball field and you trip in a boggy marsh. And who's there? Underneath the waves? What if he goes underneath? Where are you going to swing the bat? How useless is that going to be?
I'm just going to keep swinging until I kill him, Dom.
Yeah, but, okay, I'm just asking, what is your tactic to be able to hit him effectively and accurately?
So since Zordon threw us into this and it's not an accidental fight.
Yes.
Alright, I arrive at the lagoon, I'm ready to go, I've got my bat.
Yes.
Alright, I assume he knows the fight's about to happen, so he's standing there in the lagoon, he's like...
he's doing the rocks bring it pose.
With his big claws and flappy hands.
I jump off the embankment at him with the bat. Yeah. And we'll go from there, like a tussle.
I'm sorry, so wait, you're jumping into the water.
Yeah.
Trying to swing down at him with your bat.
Yeah.
Like to land that first hit to finish the fight.
I don't reckon he'll survive after the first hit.
I don't think he'll get the first hit.
I don't reckon they'll expect me to be dumb enough to jump into the lagoon.
Maybe.
The sheer surprise of when I appear, strip naked, and jump at him with a baseball bat.
You were wearing what you were wearing now.
But I'll strip.
We established that.
I know, that's why I said I'll strip naked.
But then he's got time to prepare.
He'll just be like, what's he doing?
He's taking your clothes off, and presumably he'll be like, oh, well, he's going to jump in the water then.
Is he, though? He'll be like, okay, this guy wants to go Greek style. Round and round the merry-go-round, as it were.
Of course. Look,
I better get my oil.
It's canonical that the swamp man, what's his name?
Gillman.
Gillman.
The creature from the Black Lagoon.
The creature from the Black Lagoon is a huge, what did you say? I've already forgotten the joke I was about to make. He canonically is a huge fan of Greco-Roman wrestling.
Yeah, of course.
I mean, he does want to bang that chick.
Yes, that's true.
I was just looking up
pictures of her. She's pretty cute.
Yeah.
But isn't the creature from the Black Lagoon, like, muscular? Like, he's a toughie.
He's big, yeah. He's big, he's scaly, and he's got claws.
Yeah.
I'll still bash his head. I've got a bait.
And he's got advantage in water. Look, here's what I'm thinking is going to happen, right? You strip nude. He's there. He's like, okay, that's happening. He can leave the water, by the way. So you taking off your clothes, he can go after you in that moment.
What about the leeches, Ben? What about the leeches?
What about the leeches, Dom?
But say you take off your clothes, he's waited for you, and then you jump. I don't think the surprise is going to stop him from moving out of the way of your baseball bat and then dragging you down under the water.
Then I just scratch his eyes.
I just feel like
with just your hands
underestimating.
Oh, I'm sorry, Phoenix. Have you ever had a finger shoved in your eyeball?
No, but he's imagine a your eyeballs, fish man.
Imagine your eyeballs are the size of your fucking face.
Uh-huh.
That's the Gillman's eyes. You've seen pictures of him. He's got big eyes. That's a lot of room to claw at him. I'll just reach in and pull it out.
Like
the beginning of One Punch Man, where he has the flashback and he gets the Crab Man.
I just feel like by choosing a bat, you're just. Like, the fish man is an intelligent creature.
He's not! The gill man is not intelligent, alright?
Intelligent enough.
No, he's not.
To steal the girl.
No,
the guy.
He's going off of pure and nothing else but instincts. He's not an intelligent... He can't make a plan.
You're just challenging him to a no DQ match.
Which I'll win!
But I feel like that you could come up with something that gives you much more of a distinct advantage than just a baseball bat.
Yeah, but I don't own anything. I might be able to get myself one of my pairs of brass knucks.
That also
yeah, helpful. That's worse than...
That's why I'm just going to go in there and claw his fucking eye.
What about...
You have knives.
Yeah, but I don't want it. That's too easy.
Too easy?
Your plan is to hit him in... Like, get him down in one hit with a baseball bat.
I never said I'd get him in one hit. I said after I hit him with the thing, he'd be knocked a bit loopy and then I'll be able to get more hits in.
But at
this point, you're underwater.
No, I'm not.
What about you bring a bag?
I don't understand your plan.
My plan is this. Get there. Kabat. Jump off of embankment onto Lagoon Boy.
Yes.
Smack his brain in.
Yes.
If he grabs me and tries to pull me under, grab his eyeball, pull it out of his head. While he's reeling from the fact he's now missing a fucking eye, stick my hand in his head. Swivel it around his brain. Swim to the surface, breathe, bring bat down on face.
So here's how I'm going to lay this out. This is how I picture this fight going, right? You jump, you hit him on the head. He's like, oh, a little bit loopy. You're in the water. He grabs your leg, starts pulling you down. You are above him and can't reach his arm and drown.
I mean... It's a lagoon, Phoenix.
I looked at the pictures. It's deep enough to take you down.
No, it's not.
I'm getting that picture up.
I'm looking at the exact, like, the fucking classic picture of him standing in knee-deep fucking water holding the woman.
Oh, like you're right on the edge of it.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a money on the bank match.
On the...
You gotta have... It's gotta be mutual agreed upon. It's still his home turf. But it's just enough of my home turf that I can get it going.
Okay.
That's fair. Like, I feel like...
The Gillman doesn't survive for very long out of water.
If Ben doesn't get a home field advantage by being on land, then I guess it's kind of unfair for the Gillman to have an unfair advantage of being in, like, just swimming in the top of a lake that's, like, deep.
Yeah.
So a bank seems like a good thing.
I'm on a slope. I'm already at a disadvantage. You know how bad I do with slopes.
But you coming from the land side are on the high ground, and so it's over, Anakin.
What would you give me? Out of five.
Out of five. Okay, because out of 10, I could have given you a lower score.
Okay, out of 10 then.
I will give you 6 or 7.
All right then. What about you, Tom?
Yeah, I'm feeling 6.
All right, I'm gonna write that down.
It would be a 7 because it probably, I feel like it probably would work. However, I just don't feel like I feel like you could come up with something that takes
more advantage
of the
Gillman's
weaknesses.
I feel like
you've got to
be more agile for it to work.
Nah, strength. I'll just like drunken master his ass.
Suplex.
Well, what can you fucking do then? Who are you going
to
fight?
Who I'm going to fight? Okay. So we're in like home turf, right?
Semi.
It's neutral ground. Tell us who it is and we'll figure out where it takes place.
The Invisible Man.
You're in the like, lobby of his laboratory.
Yep, that's fine. Yep.
So he walks out of a door, and you're there at the reception signing in.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
And then he, like, I have a baseball bat.
Hey, brother!
He's just a dude.
He's a dude. That's okay, invisible. Which invisible man?
Like classic H.G. Wells, like the Invisible Man movie. He's just a guy that's invisible.
Right. That doesn't answer my fucking question. What, like, as in wrapped in bandages with trench coat or naked man?
Either. Like either it's still just going to be me womping on a regular dude with a baseball bat.
I reckon he's come out of his lab. He's got, like, a hat on and some goggles and, like, a lab coat.
Sure.
But the rest of him is invisible.
Yeah.
So he sees that you're here, and he knows that there's a fight about to happen, as do you.
Yes.
So he sheds those items real quick and ducks back into his lab.
Into his lab?
Yeah.
Okay.
Where you, now that he's behind a closed door and nude, you can't see him at all.
Mm-hmm.
So you'd go up there to try to get in, and you go in and you'd be like, oh shit, where is he?
Right.
Because he's invisible.
He's invisible.
In his lab. Yes. He's lured you into his home turf.
Okay, I thought I was already in his home turf with it being the reception. Yep.
I mean, it's mutual ground.
Yeah.
Like, I don't reckon he's as familiar with the reception area as he is with the actual laboratory.
Okay, fair enough.
His tools aren't, like, readily at his disposal. Yeah.
He needs his tools, Phoenix.
Of course.
The Invisible Man's tools.
So I go in there, I got my baseball bat, I just close the door behind, and I just start swinging.
There's lights, he sees you.
That's fine.
He might just throw shit at you.
Then I know where he's coming from.
Then he can just
And I've got a baseball bat to knock the things he's throwing out of the way.
He does a Spider-Man, gets behind something big and just pushes it over on you. Like a rack.
A rack.
Like a big shelf rack.
Right.
Of potions and
whatnot. Potions.
He just causes a chemical spill. And wins.
I don't think so. Right? Because, one, if something's falling behind me, I'm not, like, an idiot. I can hear things moving.
I mean, you're a bit of an idiot.
Yes, but I can hear things.
You trip over nothing frequently.
That's true, but I can hear well enough.
Actually, I didn't even consider that. I reckon your clumsiness is what does you in.
No.
I reckon like you go in, you start swinging, and you get too into it, and you swing too much, and you fall down, and he seizes the opportunity and mounts you, knees on either side of your head, balls in your face, hammer fists down.
Well, I absolutely think that Phoenix's reckless approach to just brute forcing this problem is what's going to do him
in.
Because the Invisible Man...
Ben's whole idea was to go and jump in a lake with a baseball bat and a guy covered in scales.
Yeah, but I've proven time and again that I can actually handle stupid ideas, whereas you're a clumsy fuck.
The biggest difference between the two is that Ben can actually see the guy he's trying to hit.
Yeah, but I don't need to. I just have to keep swinging until I hit. One hit's all it's going to take.
You'll fall down.
He can just leave the room.
How often do I fall,
then? And you tire yourself out.
I dip.
The moment you get off balance, he's seizing the opportunity. He'll throw something at you while you're off balance trying to regain it. That'll knock you down. Then you'll be down. Then he'll do something that'll get him the victory. He might duck out of the room, come back with a gun.
You're wasting all your energy, Phoenix.
No, I don't think so, right?
Your only hope...
Because I've closed it. I've locked the door behind me.
He didn't say that.
I said I closed the door!
He didn't say he locked it.
Okay, sorry.
Also, but on the other note, you think there's only one entrance to the fucking lab? Or what I reckon your best bet is to go in there, and because it's a laboratory, there has to be fire equipment.
Sure.
Set off a fire, grab a fire extinguisher off the wall,
and
then
just spray.
Then you can see.
But we're talking about early, like, classic movies, right? Fire safety wasn't a thing.
Your idea, well, you need to make
if
some-
anything-
You need to find a way to see him, Phoenix!
If anything, there'd be something like a tarp or something I could throw.
In every single Invisible Man film, that it requires him to be beaten, they need to find a way to fucking see him. That's what you need to do, otherwise you're fucked.
I think that him just throwing things at me, like you said he would do, would give me enough of an idea of where he is to get him down.
I reckon it would.
Because, again, I don't fall that often. I'm not, like so clumsy that I'm going to just trip over nothing while I'm in a fight.
Aren't you?
No!
You were standing still the other week, and you instantly were like, whoa!
Yeah, but
you
I
were standing
moving.
Still!
But at this point, I'm moving, where I'm the most balanced.
What do you think?
Well, okay, so, I was going to, pick the Invisible Man until Phoenix just did now.
Sure.
But my first thought was, like, in wrestling, he'll spray black mist on their opponents. So, like, you spit stuff, but I didn't have access to that. So my thought was, and this is, I think it's better than yours, is baby powder. Because I have a lot of baby powder at home.
Why?
And listen, you know, sometimes you just don't feel like walking around with a swamp crotch all day.
I'm with you. Yeah, as someone who chafes real bad, I understand the need for this kind of thing.
We aren't all Gillman.
We aren't all full swamp body.
And so not only will the baby powder allow you to see the Invisible Man if you just like and try to get it on him, you can also use it to blind him.
Mm. What if we used fire equipment, though?
Which we all have.
I mean, like,
we're in the lab, right?
Like I said to you.
Yeah, well, like he said, you said
blind him.
No, I said so you could fucking see him. And I never said anything about blinding
him. That's a fire extinguisher.
Yeah.
I don't mean that. I mean, like, set a fire with some Bunsen burners.
Oh, now I'm on board.
Right? Smoke's going all over the place.
Here we go.
I can see him moving through the smoke.
There you go.
Yeah. You finally
Now it's you versus smoke inhalation and the Invisible Man.
And you still get to keep your thing because the smoke will be on his end.
Yeah.
Yeah. What was the thing you brought with you?
Baseball bat.
Damn it.
I could take a sword, but none of them are sharp.
Yeah. I was thinking that too. I've got a
replica. I have an axe. I could take an axe with me.
A Finn's sword from Adventure Time, but it's plastic.
So, you've lit the fire.
Yep. Lab's on fire. Only one way out. There's
multiple exits.
This is like the 50s. There was only one way out of any building.
I reckon you've got maybe a 6 out of 10 chance of winning.
I would give you a 5 or a 4.
Look, I think that I've got a better chance of winning than he does of the swamp monster who has claws.
I think that you're underestimating the difference between a swamp thing or the Black Lagoon, the creature from the Black Lagoon, and the intelligence of the Invisible Man.
The Invisible Man is a notorious trickster.
Yeah.
Sure.
He's a strategist. He's intelligent. He's got you in that.
He's also crazy, though.
To me.
No, he is. I've read the book.
Yeah, he might be crazy, but he's crazy still fucking intelligent.
Crazy like a fox.
Him crazy and on his worst day is still better than you and your best.
Wow, rude.
Like, Ben fighting the creature from the Black Lagoon is like him trying to fight a moose. like I think he's underestimating the strength of the moose, but the moose isn't going to outsmart him anytime soon.
Sure.
I reckon the moose would outsmart him.
Whereas you fighting the Invisible Man, a notorious trickster who you can't see.
You might have beat him. You've beat him in pure strength. I'll give you that. You'll beat him in brute force. Ripped. But you won't.
The listeners don't know this, but Phoenix is actually shredded to the core.
You've got him beat on the physical aspect, but you won't have him beat on the strategy and the intelligence.
Sure.
But that's why I'm giving you like a 6, because I reckon you might
cinch it. I think I could beat him.
Okay.
Dom,
you guys probably aren't gonna like my thing.
Oh, I'm already against it then.
Wolfman.
Yep.
Right. I'm into it.
Yep. I bring with me a basketball.
That's Teen Wolf.
Same difference?
No.
Here's the thing. We all know from watching Teen Wolf, the 90s, 80s, the 80s documentary on wolf people.
Yeah.
That wolf people love basketball.
It's true.
And I don't think the Wolfman would be able to resist challenging me to a basketball match. And now...
Yep.
The Wolfman would still have a huge advantage.
Yeah, because he's a Wolfman.
But less so than a fight. So I'm just raising my chances of winning by a considerable margin.
Because even though...
But I'm still at a disadvantage.
Even though Ben said it's fight, it definitely just says defeat.
Yeah.
All right. Well, see, this is the thing. Like, it would be a fight, but then I would convince him to play basketball.
Yeah, to play basketball.
Okay, so which Wolfman?
What's the name of Marty McFly?
Michael J. Fox. You want
Michael
Teen
J. Fox?
So you don't want Wolfman at all. You want Teen Wolf?
Well,
different kind of thing.
No. I don't want Teen Wolf because Teen Wolf has proven that he's very good at basketball.
He's very good,
and that might be just one off.
What you want is whoever the new Teen Wolf kid is, from the terrible TV show.
Yeah.
Because he's a lacrosse player.
There we go.
Challenge him at basketball. That's and it. He's what, not what gonna about, have the advantage. Other than his wolf.
Jacob powers. From Twilight. Does that count?
No.
No, he's not a wolf man. Man,
he's a, like,
okay, so the wolf man is from the 1941 film The Wolf Man.
Yes.
That was before basketball was invented.
Yeah.
As we all know.
He was involved in four sequels, beginning with Frankenstein Meets the Wolfman in 1943.
Classic.
So, essentially, you've just got a bloke who's a wolf.
Yes. Who wants to play basketball.
No.
Definitely wants to play basketball. He's going to see that ball. It's like, programmed in a wolfman's brain that we need to bounce this ball and throw it through a hoop.
Throw it through a hoop. And I'm going to trick him. Wait, I can't bring multiple things. No. I'm going to trick him. Because it will take place in a basketball court, which, if anything, I think is the Wolfman's home field advantage. Yeah,
absolutely.
And I'm going to trick him into thinking that my hoop is his one.
Yep.
And so he'll just keep scoring own goals.
Okay. The Wolfman's still the full moon thing, right?
Okay, so the Wolfman, the actual Wolfman...
Yeah.
Yeah. Michael J. Fox.
No.
No.
From the film The Wolfman...
Yeah.
Is a dude who was bitten by a wolf, a werewolf, and he transforms into a werewolf by night and such. When the he may become a wolf when the wolfbane blooms and the autumn moon is bright.
Yeah.
So full moon, autumn, wolfbane must be blooming.
Yeah.
He's a werewolf.
Yes.
You're fucked.
I disagree. Basketball's a good idea.
Basketball.
It won't want to play. It's not intelligent.
There's no way that I'm going to be able... Well, see, this is the thing. That's what I'm taking advantage of by convincing him that...
You can't... No. You can't convince him, though, because he's too rabid.
And here's the thing about the Wolfman. Yeah. He's only a Wolfman during the full moon. So you get him to play basketball just during the day.
You have to fight the Wolfman. You have to fight the monster.
I'm on Ben's side of this. I'm going to fight the wolf.
You'll lose... Because you'll be like, I want to play a game of basketball with you. And it'll be like, and then bite you to death because you won't have convinced it because it's a fucking rabid animal.
I am relying on the fact that wolfmen have instincts to want to play basketball. Yeah, but he's not intelligent enough to understand
the rules. Did you see the documentary?
Yeah, did you see
Teen the Wolf?
You mean the film that's about black people?
Yeah.
Is it?
It is.
Is that what it's a metaphor
Teen Wolf
for?
Is a metaphor for black people.
Oh, wow. I haven't seen Teen Wolf.
Anyway,
100% honest with you guys.
It's a good movie. You should watch it. Anyway, I give you a 9. I think that's a great idea. Thank you.
I feel like I'm gonna win by averaging this out.
I'm giving you a 4.
Oh,
I reckon at worst he might bite you, and then you'll get Wolfman powers as well.
Hey, go, and then I'll be just as good.
Here's the thing, right? At basketball.
Why didn't I think of that?
Here's the thing: is that that 9 and that 4. That still equals 13, which is 1 point better than I got, so...
What's 6 plus 7?
6 plus 7 is 13. Didn't you guys both give me 6?
No, I gave you a 6. He gave you a 4 or a 5.
Ah, dang.
I gave you the best case scenario with him and gave you a 5. So, would you like to change your Incident Phoenix for, like, say, a 7?
Don't worry about it.
Why, would that make Phoenix win?
That would make him tie with us.
Oh. Okay, Phoenix, convince me, give me one extra detail that will convince me that it's a 7. And not...
What, fighting the invisible man?
Or convince me to make it a 7.
He doesn't have any weapons.
He's got a dick.
Okay.
He's not a weapon.
Phoenix gets
a 7. It's a hindrance.
Phoenix gets a 7 just based on the fact that you assumed that the Invisible Man has a huge dick. And if that's true, yeah, Phoenix is right. It's a hindrance.
Alright, so with a score of 13 for me,
yeah,
13 for Phoenix,
yeah,
and 13 for Dom.
Thank you.
Out of 20 each, we all tie, meaning we'd all win because we beat the average of 10.
Yes.
Fantastic.
Good. So on that note, I've been the guy who beat the Gillman.
I'm the guy that beat the Invisible Man.
And I'm the guy that became the new Teen Wolf.
Nice. If you reckon you could beat a classic monster movie villain, or you reckon that the Invisible Man doesn't have a big monster dong, tweet us, @FromHat on Twitter, or email us, FromHatPodcast@gmail.com.
Do you reckon the Invisible Man and Swordon Lord of
Bringer of Corn.
Bringer of Corn. Corn Space Time. Like, took their sizes off.
I reckon Zordon, because I've seen it. It's like a, it's just a big dick that's made of corn.
Yeah.
I reckon it.
To contact Phoenix and Ben, email them at fromahatpodcast@gmail.com or go to our Facebook or Twitter. Links are in the description.